So we got the big summit between President Trump and Kim Jong-un. We'll have all the details, analysis, what happened, what went right, what went wrong tomorrow morning here on WBAL News Radio tonight. We'll be live in Singapore at 6:48 in the morning, which is 6:48 p.m. They're 12 hours ahead of us. But we did have the mayor on the show this morning, Mayor Catherine Pugh. She was up in Boston for the mayor's conference. They had like 250 mayors all there getting together, talking about the big issues. I specifically got into it with her regarding immigration and some of the policies. Is it a sanctuary city? Is it not a sanctuary city? And what she hopes will happen with the census question. The Trump administration wants to put back on the short form the question of whether or not you are legally in this country or not. Most of the mayors don't want that to happen. They're afraid that people won't fill it out and therefore that they won't be counted in the census and they'll lose federal dollars for it. It's a hot button issue because, well, if you're not in the country illegally, should you be counted? We got into it. Me and the mayor this morning, Catherine Pugh here on WBAL News Radio 1090.
Well, immigration around ID, you know, we just met with Bill in Baltimore. The city is creating its own ID for immigrants and also the parish ID, which is one of Bill's ideas to make sure that people feel safe as they move around our cities. Baltimore is not considered a sanctuary city because we don't control our prisons, but what we want to make sure is that people feel safe moving around, approaching the police when they have different issues and so forth. And so that's something that most cities are looking at as well. The other issue is around affordable housing. And we are one of the cities of six cities in the United States that are vying for a Promised Neighborhood grant. There will be three given out. So that was good information for us, but also sharing with other mayors around private-public partnerships and job creation and understanding what's being done in other cities to create more jobs and opportunities as many of the cities are growing in population. So that brings into the discussion around violence.
Can I drill down on the question regarding the identification? How would that? Can you explain how that would work with an illegal immigrant getting this kind of identification? How would that play out?
Well, it's not illegal immigrants. I mean, we're talking about immigrants in our city who are vying for citizenship, and people who are coming to our city. They have no fear of going to their churches and so forth to get identification. But the city is also creating identification as well because there are people who are also going through the citizenship process. And so you want to make sure that they have a fair and equal access to that opportunity.
So this is someone who's already in the system trying to become a legal citizen?
There are some people who want to get into the system. There are some people who are trying to get into the system and some people who are already in the system.
Okay. There is going to be the question on the census about whether or not the household members are citizens of the country. Have you made a determination on what you want citizens in Baltimore to do on that?
Well, let me just say I chair the U.S. Census for the U.S. Conference of Mayors, and so, you know, there is a lawsuit, and Maryland has joined in that lawsuit to make sure that that question does not appear on the census. That decision has not been made as of yet because it is still in the courts and still being heard. So we're looking forward to the outcome of that, and hopefully it'll be favorable. But I think it's not since 1950 has such a question been on the census, because the idea of the census is to count everyone who is living in a particular jurisdiction because they utilize the resources, and that is the way by which federal dollars are determined to flow into cities.
Right, but it has been on the long form, and it's always been on the long form census questionnaire. I mean, this is just the short term.
It's not on the form. It's been on the form in 1950 and was taken off of the form.
Right, but the long form, it has always been on it, the way I understand it.
Well, the way that we understand it is that it has not, or that it should not be. And that is the lawsuit that the mayors, the 161 mayors, signed on to that is being heard currently.
I guess my question is, do you really think that someone who was in the country illegally would have answered before this question was on? I mean, would they have even answered in the first place, you know, 4 years ago or 5 years ago versus what they would do today if this question is on the ballot?
I think when it's fully explained that some folks do, whether they're illegal or not, do pay taxes, that this is a way for jurisdictions to get back money to provide services for individuals. And so I think the fear that exists now is around the climate in the country.
Mm-hmm.
And so what we want to do is make sure that, you know, the resources that our cities are in need of do come back. And so there will be encouragement on our behalf to get people to, in fact, fill out the form.
So you would you, if it is on the form, if that question is on the form, do you want people to answer it or not?
I don't think anyone should answer it because it's not on the form, and it wasn't on the form and hasn't been on the form since 1950. What we want is to make sure that we get our resources that are needed from the federal government, whether it is for affordable housing, job creation, infrastructure needs, all of these things that plague our city and cities throughout this country. That's the discussion that's being had here.
Okay. But I just want to make sure that you would advise residents just to keep it blank, to not answer it then if it wasn't on it.
There has been discussion around whether no one should answer the question, since that is not the purpose of the census. The purpose of the census is to count every individual that is living within your jurisdiction, because they utilize resources and they do pay taxes, and as a result of that, you get a certain amount of resources. The only persons who have not been required to answer that, who don't pay taxes in this country, are Native Americans.
Great. We'll leave it there. Mayor, great to have you on as always. Appreciate coming on the show.
Thank you so much.
Mayor Catherine Pugh, live from Boston for the Conference of Mayors here on WBAL News Radio.